We're back. Speak with Bran about more work. So we received this quest last time we logged out. So let's do it.
If you're here to sell something, we don't want any.
Alright, goodbye.
Careful out there.
Yeah, we can recruit this
What's
guy.
Up?
Tell your support officer that you'll be leaving your post to join my NTR unit. Oh.
Hello.
I wish you would have said hello, that would have been sick. Yeah, and sorry about last time for the disturbing content. So, another warning, there may be some other disturbing words and ideas thrown about in this episode, but I'm sure you can handle it. So, yeah.
Excuse me a moment. You're wanted at Ranger Station Foxtrot. Sounded urgent. Of course, everything Rangers say sounds urgent. Sounds like the man to speak with is a Ranger named Early. I don't know any more than that. I'd ask him if you want the details.
Alright, let's go there. Lucky we discovered that last time. Or a few episodes ago. It's witchcraft. Hopefully my mic should be a lot better this time. Last time it was too loud.
You better get out of here.
Oh, there's our boy. Walking away. Get him back, actually. Follow. He doesn't care, he's running away.
Hey!
Why is he attacking them?
You like that?
Who died? Oh, I guess I don't like him. There's all of our stuff that we lost. I'll take all of it, give it to someone else. Routine human. Let's try it again. He's gonna have to just die. Oh well, just have to wait. Whilst he's doing that, I can sort out my inventory. This outfit's cool. It's pretty cool. Pretty cool. What's this benefactor outfit? Oh yeah, we need to wear the, where is it? Is it, we have extra health, extra, storage if we, this is good enough. Try and drop some stuff. If I don't need that. Don't really need that. Don't need that. Don't need those. Don't need those. Don't need those. Don't need that. Don't need that. Believe me. Don't need these. Don't need those. I'm dropping kind of some expensive stuff, but it'll be worth it if we have enough base my inventory. Oh, these are heavy. Anything else? With a laughing face. Drop those. Have you ever heard mission bells ringing? Well, she'll give you the very same glow. Then the glass we can repair. When she speaks, you that should be good. Well, it's good. Gotta wait for Mac to die now. And he's got a lot of health. But I am the robot god. You can't resist. I had to sorry for you. Tap into this fabric of reality to kill him, but what can you do? No angel. I don't know why they turned on him anyway.
Been hearing stories about you. Some kind of courier shaking the Mojave up like a hornet's nest.
You sound exactly like the other guy.
Must be some kind of dedication to your job, considering that's still your title after all the other things you've been doing. This is why I wanted to have a chat with you.
Lieutenant Brown said you had a job for me.
That I do.
Brace
heard about your little foray up north tracking that Burt kid. That's rough territory. I'm thinking you've been paid to go fugitive hunting there once before. How about an encore performance? I need someone up there dealt with.
What's the job?
Well, you know how there was that push to bring Burke, sick bastard that he is, in alive?
Yeah.
Well, that's not really an issue here. Fella up there by the name of Caleb Alkist. At the moment, his head is attached to his shoulders, and I got 10,000 caps to whoever can rectify that.
Big Pav, what's it going for?
A long damn story. Short version is he's a mass murdering lunatic, claiming the NCR authorized his killings. Which is verifiably bullshit, seeing as how those orders would have come from me, and I sure as hell never gave him the go-ahead for that.
I'll start hunting.
Good. Alright, be ready for anything. Report back to me when you're done.
Alright. Guys, we're going back to the North Road. I know how much we enjoyed it last time. Oh, it's a dead NCR. Ranger. How many people died just then? Pretty much all of them. Oh no, he's not dead. Baby, kiss me. I don't know why they didn't attack the lobotomite. Because he's like basically a creature, but never mind. Back to the North Road we go then. North Road. Please be true. So yeah, I can't make any money off these videos anyway. I don't have enough subscribers, watch time, and their copyright infringed on all the episodes because I play the actual music, but I hope you enjoy them nonetheless. So where? Up there. This should be fairly quick actually. Let's get a better gun out. Let me sing forevermore. Don't know which one this is.
Howdy. You need something from me?
Alright, Caleb, I'll come to your head.
Have you now? Well, you wouldn't be the first to try. Look, I've been doing this longer than you. Words don't really get under my skin, none. Did the client tell you who I am? You know that I killed every man, woman, and child in Brighton? Threw their corpses in a ditch and burned the goddamn town to ash. Some of them tried threatening me, just like you. But the only hesitation I had was when I had to reload. So the righteous threats of death and dismemberment, save it for someone who hasn't heard it before. Now, I imagine you're either driven by a vague sense of justice, or you're just doing something you're good at for a fair wage. Either way, I'm afraid you're shit out of luck. You draw on me here, you ain't getting either of those things.
Enough till I'm done.
Fair enough. Gonna be a lot of bullets heading your direction in a moment. So good luck.
I thought it was gonna be that tough. Told you. Caleb is dead. while that was strictly speaking the mission that the Ranger signed, you can't help but recall the entire reason you wanted to kill Deadwood because Caleb's ruthless approach to headhunting him right and he was off without damage. That in mind, it's unlikely that the Ranger Ali will appreciate you repeating history. You have a strange sense that you might have just slipped up. Wait, how did I fail? You told me to do it. You told me to kill him. What do I do now? Got a load back for? Sights well. Lol. Need to drop something. How do I even fuck up? Why? Told me to kill him. Sorry, but there should be no witnesses. Doesn't really matter, I guess. To get a mysterious stranger. We'll get another one as well in a sec. Thousand cap, it's not bad. Anything good here? We're drinking, my friend, to the end. Asleep, get healed up. Of a brief episode. Oh, more enemies. He died. Come on. Oh, you can't kill him. That's why. Let's go. He said to rectify the fact that he's alive, so I'm assuming. I assume that he wanted me to kill him, but doesn't make a lot of sense. I could tell you a lot, let's go back there, see what he's saying. You've gotta be true to your code. Let's make it one. Hello.
We won't go quietly. The Legion can count
what
on
you.
That.
Around here anywhere.
Yeah?
You're the wrong person, man.
Be careful out there.
You too.
Nice job out there.
Appreciate it. Where is it?
Hello.
I mean, I've got no quest marks, so I don't know where. The other guys are just walking around.
Patrolling the Mojave almost makes me wish.
Don't know where he is. 10,000 caps to sound nice. I
hope you didn't mind. Hey.
I don't think he's here.
But this torch that I got this assignment, I was hoping there'd be more game.
I think there's a part two to this quest that I need to install.
Hey.
Maybe. So since he's not here.
Nice job out there.
Cheers. I shall be back with a vengeance. Peace. Alright, see you in a minute. At the moment is at the strip. I may edit this out, I may not. So if you're watching this and I haven't. because I can't carry all this stuff. There's also a car and a van somewhere that has lunch junk in it too. So we shall put that away another time, but for now, we'll just put all the stuff we have away. Madness in the street.
What do you need?
I need to put my stuff away. Don't crash. We're back again. Hey. It's just too much chaos on the free side, so. Nice. Let's hope this time it will load. Shouldn't be too much happening in this shit. Now this could only happen. There, we made it. Like me. There's not many people here. And only happen. I can't sprint in somewhere. A town like this.
So may well, howdy, partner.
Thank you.
See?
Well, hold on.
Well, howdy, partner.
Thank you.
I see you brought a friend.
No problem. Give me all your stuff.
You got something to say to me?
Give me all your stuff.
If you give me something I like, you're not getting it back. Just
keep
kidding.
Going well. I'll put some stuff on you in a minute.
What can I do for you, boss?
Give me all your stuff.
I'm sure you'll be fair and equitable, boss.
We're gonna put this all away anyway. Because I want them to be able to carry stuff in case I get overcome again. I would sell a lot of this. Kind of town. Give me all your stuff. Grown. Inventory.
Something to say.
Like I said, this probably isn't a start but you're welcome to skip ahead if you want.
If you give me something I like, you're not getting it back. Just kidding.
What's on set? Where horns free. And, well, that's it. New Vegas is my kind of town, baby. Get it with me anyway. Let's just slowly pace our way there. Saturday night is the loneliest night in a week. All of our other stuff should be here. I don't mind Sunday night at all, 'cause that's the night friends come to call. So we can put our clothes. And Monday to Friday go fast, and another week is past. Find some cool stuff to wear. Have to put it all away. I sing a song that I sang for the memories I usually see. Until I'm just a slave boy robot with this backpack. Until you're in my arms once more. I'm so many buttons. Saturday night is the loneliest night of the week. Don't really need caps either, and if we do, we can just come back and install a bunch. Keep that. Yeah, we'll keep these. Now, we want Reinforced pistol. I sing the song that I sang. Best gun of the game. I would just leave it like that. Until I hear you at that door, until you're in my arms once more. Saturday night is the loneliest night. First thing I've chosen, we'll just take this. Wearing classic Fallout 1 or 2 armor. And we got our pistol. Have a little drink. Nice. At least we don't have to carry all that stuff around anymore. Until you're in my arms once more. Let me try for something.
Enjoy your time. We
deactivate it. Jesus. Wait, is he following me? Oh, he is. Cool. Someone that I wanted to get, one of our old friends, one of all of our old friends actually. You'll see who I mean when we get him. Gotta find him first though. So exciting, something in my heart. Alright, we've got those two people here. They can take care of them. Strangers in the night. Two lonely people, we were strangers in the night. Up to the moment when we set our first hello. Little did we know. Easy. Is that our van or is that someone else's van? Put it off. Who's these guys? For strangers in the night. someone nearby. Hello. Don't know what this is. I don't know if we've been in there before. Love was just a glance away, a warm embracing dance away. We need to go to the racetracks. Is where we need to go. Vault 9. We'll leave that for now. Might be part of the quest. Oh, there's our old friend. We found him. I had a message on my Pip-Boy that he was around. Is he following me?
The Kaisar has marked you for death.
Yeah, yeah. AK-47. This is what he crashed in. My friend, I'll say it clear. Deactivate. I'll state my case. Cannot be repaired. I just deactivated him. I've lived a life that's full. I'll report to him. Maybe I can repair him. I know it's very sad to see, but I wasn't sure if he was following me or not. Cannot be repaired. Oh, we just killed R2-D2. It was all your fault, Dino. Don't tell me it wasn't, because it was. Bam, just a warning. That sucks. It sucks, and do you have anything good? Not really. There's also something Nick Goodsprings I heard about. Each charted course, each careful step along the byway. Sorry about that, guys. Who's this?
What do you need?
Some stuff.
Hello.
Run there. It's behind the schoolhouse, I think. Schoolhouse is here. It might be in the schoolhouse, I'm not sure. There it is. Yeah. Take all of it. Been given to our companions. So what have we got here? The Tomo Punk. That is sweet. What does the helmet look like? Oh, that's sick. I've had my fill, my share of losing, and now Cyberpunk outfit, which is also sick. I can't really wear it.
How's it going, buddy?
Let's trade.
If you give me something I like, you're not getting it back. Just kidding.
Take that. Yeah, it's pimped out. That's also pretty sick. I did it. That's sick too. That's also pretty sick. Yeah, Ross.
What can I do for you, boss?
Let's trade.
I expect to be awed by your dizzy mercantile sense, boss.
No, I want to steal from that. Let's yeah, it looks cool. Put the steampunk on me. Yeah, I'm pimped out. Let's take a screenshot. Alright. Now on with the quest that we're gonna do. We never found the generator, did we? Someone. The west side. Yeah, so hopefully these videos, you can just chill out and watch that. But I do warn you, this next mod is very disturbing, apparently. So be warned. Oh, the lag is real.
The tower on the strip, the one you can see for miles.
Okay, it's not here.
I hear it ain't sealed up. I've got you
deep in the heart. Where is he? So deep in my heart that you're really a part of me. I've got you. Hopefully he's here. Under my skin. Come back to the wood. I tried so not to give in. Just gonna look around. I said to myself, prepare. So well. But why should I try to resist? It's pretty cool map. Well, what happened there? I've got you under my skin. Instead of being the watchtower on the pit boy communication. That's the watchtower over there, I think. Unless there's another one. Going around, let's have a look. Don't you know, little fool, you never can win. Use your mentality. Wake up to reality. But each time that I do, just the thought of you makes me stop before I begin. This guy looks serious. How's it feel? Don't think he's here. A bunch of fiends are on. Another look over here. I would sacrifice anything, come what might, for the sake of having you near, in spite of a warning voice. I mean, this is the watchtower, right? And repeats how it yells in my ear.
Well, I mean, some of the pictures on our side. You never can win.
Why not? I mean, these are watchtowers too. Step up,
wake up. Yeah? What? Not meaning to be rude, but I'm pretty busy here.
Been having nothing to do to help out.
Well, now you're in for it. Best get ready to work yourself into an early grave, because there's a mountain of shit that needs to be done. Let's start off with something simple. Some scorpion prick managed to waylay a courier that was supposed to bring us a crate of seeds. Our crops are keeping us self-sufficient for the moment, so the more crops we can grow, the better. And we already paid for these seeds, damn it. So, if you could jog over to Monte Carlo and retrieve the shipment, that'd be great. Good luck.
Cool, we'll do that. This must be new. I don't remember this being new. When I was 17, it was a very good year. We'll change the radio in a sec. We've heard this many times.
Small town girls and soft
summer night.
Who else have we got?
We'd hide from the light.
Where did Elvis? Feed some seeds on. Some distinguished gentlemen we are. Imagine this group running up to you. So scared.
Good. That should help us keep our people fed. And maybe make a little profit, too. Thanks for that.
Welcome.
But, as anyone unfortunate enough to sign up for this militia knows, the work never stops. I got another job for you. I'll keep it simple. A little to the south is an old motel building. It's a short walk, don't worry. I just can't leave my post and all that. There's a woman named Luisa living there, along with her husband, Hector. I need you to go get her up and escort her over here to me. See, Hector is a piece of shit. He likes drugs and liquor and beating the shit out of his wife. Hence, why I need her escorted.
Oh, I wanna...
Right. Off you go, then.
This way. Uh-oh. Sad. I want your fresh girls. For so many nights, my darling. Literally just around the corner. I should have just walked them.
You're back. Where's Luisa?
Hector killed her before I got there. He's dead now, too.
God fucking damn it. Fucking hell! You know what? There's a lesson here. Fuck the benefit of the doubt, I should have put a bullet in his head years ago. But I couldn't do that. No. I thought there had to be a line we couldn't cross. We couldn't be a vigilante execution squad. So I didn't kill him. You see what I have to deal with? I'm defending the citizens here. But I failed to defend half of them. And I want to personally execute the rest.
Look, this was two people, not the entire town. You didn't do anything wrong.
Yeah, maybe. All I know is two people are dead at the wrong time. One died way too soon, the other should have died years ago. Anyway, there's more shit that needs to be done. Of course, it never ends.
Alright, so what's the next trip?
I need you to deliver a package to a ghoul named Cliff. He should be hanging out behind the old house tools building. Might be a few fiends in the area, but it shouldn't be too much effort. Here, please don't lose it.
What's this package?
Payment. Cliff has a shitload of ancient, terrible guns that he sells in bulk for dirt cheap. They're borderline useless, but but I'm trying to keep everyone armed, and I sell the extras for spare parts.
Oh, I wanna...
Right. Off you go, then.
Cool. So we're just doing a bunch of jobs for this guy. Goodbye. I'll just imagine fast travel and just like running really fast for the whole group. Not in here.
Howdy.
Howdy. Hello.
What?
Oh, a package for you.
Ah, good, yes. Tell him I'll send a full crate over by the end of the week. Good doing business.
Goodbye.
Adios. Keep an eye out for fiends, and they're lurking around this area.
Yikes. Who's this guy? Nick Adventure. Oh yeah, these really hard difficulties. Yeah, these ones aren't so hard. He's dead. Got an idea. Next time we get one of these guys down, maybe turn him into a companion. All right, let's go back. Oh, we'll just run there. Probably gonna be more fiends.
Some cons got cornered in the ruins of Boulder City.
Dun dun dun. Oh, the lag.
What's up?
Deliver the package.
Good. I'd hate to rely on these ancient pieces of garbage, but if the fiends ever attacked us in force, they might make a difference. Well, thanks for that. Take some of the load off my shoulders. A bit. That's about all the work I can delegate to you. The remaining shit kinda has to fall on me or one of the other townies. You know how it is. Although, there's one small thing you could do for me. It's more of a personal matter. Sort of. You willing to help me with one last thing?
Sure, I'll help.
Great. So, when I say this is a personal matter, I mean it's a family thing. I'd like you to check in with my niece. She's my brother Jerry's daughter. Jerry. He's not doing well. His son was killed a while back and his wife left him for another man. The bitch wasn't interested in caring for her remaining child, so she left the kid with Jerry. And Jerry, he hit the bottle. Hard. A lot of us felt he wasn't fit to take care of his kid in this state. Rather than try to shape up, he sent her to some religious institution. Maybe my drunk-ass brother doesn't care much for family. But I do, damn it. I need to check in on Jessie. See if she's alright. As for this religious center, I don't know where it is. You'll have to speak with Jerry. He should be somewhere in town. Shit-faced and angry. If I tried talking to him, he'd spit on my shoes. We don't really get along much these days. Thanks again.
I have a feeling that this is gonna be quite dark. I thought this was a part two to the North Road, but I think it's something completely different. I don't know if we'll ever get closure on what happened on the North Road, to be honest. I mean, we might, but I doubt it. Dun, dun. Well, let's find Jerry.
Howdy.
Howdy, cowboy. Why's he killing him?
Made in the USA.
Hold on. I'm not even going around killing people. I knew this mob would be useful. Anyone else die?
Fuck off, kid. I'm busy.
Just saved you, bro. Whoa, who's this up here? That mean son of a bitch. How'd he even die? Probably from this guy. Couldn't be here. I mean, I'm alright with him because Robert's gonna attack me, but everyone else. Come on, miss him.
Hello.
The fuck you want? I could kick your ass, man. Just not right now. Gotta piss first.
Well, I want to check up on your daughter, Narka Panda.
Oh, you talked to Ryan, did you? Why don't you go back to him, okay, and tell him to stay the fuck out of my fucking business? I need my fucking baby brother looking after my shit. Fuck Ryan and fuck you too, fucker. He fucking told me I wasn't being a good dad, couldn't take care of Jesse like that was fucking news. Motherfucker, I watched my first kid get shot to shit by fiend cocksuckers, and Ryan thinks I'm not aware that I'm a shit parent. I told him, I said, motherfucker, if you care so goddamn much about her, you fucking take her. Oh no, can't do that, he doesn't have room. Whatever. And her filthy, lying cunt of a mother, she won't do shit. She's too busy getting fucked by fat, rich NCR bitches. Can't be bothered to help her kid. Last time I saw Jess was at church building outside that Aerotech refugee park. You know, let God take care of her since I'm too fucking inept. So, the fuck you waiting for? Go look after my fucking daughter on the behalf of my sanctimonious shithead baby brother. Right. If you need me, I'll just be here. Probably lying in the gutter.
Great call.
What do you need?
It's always what do you need, or... It's always what do you need, never what do I need. Typical.
Anything new happening?
Jump time. What's this? Hello?
Some cons got cornered in the ruins of Boulder City. But the NCR let him go. That's unusual.
Come here. We can lock up this one. Any guns, any rare stuff here? The when you reduce holotapes and shit. Crazy one or blah 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 blah. Something to do with Ulysses, I think. I mean, didn't like it.
Morning.
Alright, let's travel there.
Light Ministries. My name is Monica. What can I do for you today?
We have a girl named Jessica Neal. Her uncle wants to know how she is.
That's actually an unusual request, if you don't mind me saying. The vast majority of our wards come to us with no families, or they've been abandoned. Fortunately, we keep records for all our current personnel. I can have one of our clerical workers assist you. Our archives can be found through the door on my right. Can I help you with anything else?
Goodbye.
Have a nice day.
Yes, can I help you with something?
Yes, I'm looking for information regarding one of your orphans, Jesse O'Neill.
Ah, yes. Give me one moment. Jesse O'Neill. Here we are. Jesse O'Neill, 11 years old, originally from Westside, enrolled in our ministry program 5 months ago. Her grades are rather decent. No disciplinary record to speak of. She seems to be doing rather well.
That's beautiful.
No. Firstly, in order for a non-family individual, such as yourself, to meet with one of our students, we would need a written consent form. More to the point, she isn't actually here at the moment. She is currently attending a trip to Shady Sands with 9 other students.
Oh dear.
The trip is being supervised by Deacon Paulson. They are expected to return in, let me see, 6 months' time. Before you ask, I am not at liberty to tell you where exactly you could find them. You'll just have to wait for them to return. I apologize for the inconvenience. Have a pleasant day.
I always think, like, New Vegas is such a dangerous place, like,
hey there.
How could there even be, like trips and stuff? There's just danger everywhere.
Delivery.
Who's it from?
An individual with the NCR. It's much more important than whatever you're doing now, I assure you. Have a pleasant day.
It's a letter, okay. Hello, child. My name is Specialist April Morgan with the NCR. I'm currently on a classified assignment. I know that you'd be immensely helpful to my efforts. While I can't go into details on the message, I can promise you I have the cash and incentive to aid in me. In addition to the good, it would do for the region if I am successful in this, including this message or the coordinates to the operate, and please meet me at the earliest possible convenience. Alright. Where am I supposed to go? No map marker. Ah, it's over here. Alright. Easy there, cowboy.
We won't go quiet. Legion, count.
Oh good, you showed up. Wasn't sure you'd be interested in some vague message. I'm Specialist Morgan. So, you ready to hear what we need from you? I'm positive you'll be able to handle it without trouble.
What's the job?
Just gotta make a little run to a farm shack. Maybe half hour away, tops. Pick up something, bring it on back. Easy. Not allowed to give out more details unless you accept the job, so... I'm sure you're dying of curiosity.
Followed it.
Alright, that's perfect. You're going to be heading to one of the shacks on the Horowitz farm. It's been co-opted by a person of interest we're investigating. He likely won't be there, so don't worry about that. Instead, worry about finding a gray metal briefcase. We know it's stashed in there somewhere. Get that briefcase, don't let it get shot or burned or anything silly like that, and bring it back to me. Job simple, and then you get paid. Good luck and all that.
All okay. Here we are. We've been here many times. This is where I used to put my stuff. Ah! Oh. That's pretty neat. Briefcase, thing. Smoke much? Where is it? Where was supposed to turn on? We should get through. My robot brain will absorb the information. Got nothing important though. Going upstairs. Where is it? We'll try this. Need these guys out of the way. Oops, stay there. Is it hidden or where is it? Ah, there it is. Don't know how I didn't see that.
Another glorious day in this man's army.
Indeed. This is a pretty simple question so far. Nothing outrageous has happened. Not many behemoths around these days. Normally you'd see a few by now.
Hello.
Got the briefcase? Good. Great, even. But the job isn't over. No, your next task, is to go to the room right next to mine and hand this briefcase to the hacker prick sitting at a computer. His name is Alex, and I don't like talking to him.
Hold on.
Yep.
Oh, got a little present for me, do ya? Don't suppose that frigid bitch Morgan happened to include a love letter for me, eh? No, whatever. Just hand me that briefcase and let me plug this bitch in.
Suppose all these briefcases.
Well, that's what we're gonna fucking figure out because I'm a fucking god at this shit. Some encrypted conspiracy nutjob psychotic ramblings.
I'm so slick, the NCR will never know I'm onto them.
You lose, bitch. Fucking hack Feldstein only wished he could work with shit this high technical. How's your robot fuck buddy feel now, Melvin?
Hey, I'm
Wait,
a robot.
You're still here? Fuck off and let me work. Go talk to Morgan. Some of us actually have fucking jobs to do here.
Good. Looking forward to getting that information decrypted. Sorry about making you speak with Alex. Unfortunately, he's picked up on the fact that he's good enough at his job that we can't quite fire him for being a twat. Whatever. Good news, you're getting paid now. Hooray.
Well, I don't think you even told me how much you've been paid.
Oh, well, let me address that right now. Here you go. An extra reward is that I get to let you in on a little secret. It turns out, I'm not actually in the military. No, this is actually an Office of Mojave Affairs operation. This briefcase runaround? Just seeing if we could rely on you. Now, don't worry yourself over this bureaucratic nonsense. Just a formality. I think I may have a related job here. Let me see if they've forwarded me the file.
Do I have a job for me or not?
Turns out I do. Good. Here's a dossier on this guy. You can read it or not. Now, Blake, the lunatic who had that briefcase you retrieved, is almost certainly in correspondence with this guy in the dossier here.
Eddie Hurst, who is this?
That's the name. Supposedly. Hurst worked in close proximity to some government officials about a decade ago. Seems he may have been collecting some privileged information. I won't bore you with the classified specifics, but Hurst is implicated in selling some intelligence to Blake, our briefcase thief. Hurst is holed up in Red Rock Canyon, we believe, shacked up with some great con friends of his. We need a third party, you, to make contact with Hurst. Do whatever you need to do to squeeze Blake's location from him. Oh, yes. On a different note, here's something you may be interested in. I hired an assassin for you.
Excuse me?
Did I get you going? Yes, I've contracted an assassin, a rather skilled one, to back you up, if you deem it necessary. You're quite an asset to the office. It wouldn't do for you to fall prey to angry raiders or Legion Retribution squads. This assassin said you could contact them in Freeside. It's near that water pump. I'll mark it on your map there. All right, that's all I have for you. Let me know what sorts of valuable intelligence you can squeeze out of Hurst.
All right, I'm gonna do a couple more things, and then I'm gonna power down for the day. I still talk to Ryan about his niece. Oh, lag.
Some cons got cornered in the ruins of Boulder City.
What's up? Yep.
I went to the church. She said Jessica was on a field trip to California tomorrow.
Great. That's great. She's being indoctrinated into an NCR saluting little drone. I can take some solace in the fact she's safe, I guess. Still, it'd be nice to know for sure, instead of hearing about things secondhand. Who told you she was in California? Some paper pusher? Fuck it. Go over his head. If you're still interested in helping me with this family bullshit, maybe you could talk to the guy in charge? See if you can chat with the guy running that church. See if he can offer any clarity, I guess. Hell, I don't know. Oh yeah, One other thing came up while you were gone. Before you got all wrapped up in the perpetual O'Neill family bullshit, you were helping me with peacekeeping shit, so... A friend of mine from out of town is having some raider trouble. I volunteered your name. Sorry, I guess. I don't know if you care. Anyway, if you want to help out, the place is called Humboldt Ranch. It's sort of near Bitter Springs. Tell them I sent you. Thanks. I appreciate it.
Cool. Alright. So we shall do that next time. See you guys.